The Raton Racino is not meant to be. After failing to make repeated deadlines, the state revoked the Racino's gaming license. Rod Green has more on the future of the project.
If you were a gambling man, what chances would you give it?
50-50? No, it's better than that.
As Mayor Jesse James Johnson and a strong contingent of Raton citizens waited on pins and needles for the Gaming Control Board to make a final decision on the Racino, it spent nearly 5 hours behind closed doors. When the doors opened, there was a decision that few people wanted to hear.
It's a sad day for the horse breeders, and it's a sad day for the horsemen in New Mexico.
With those words, Chairman David Norvell called for a vote that would put an end to plans for a racetrack and casino at Raton, at least for the time being.
What do you do now?
I'm not sure, to be honest with you. We just have to back to the drawing board, I guess.
I've invested probably $3.5 million to date. Another $3.5 million I think was planned to go out in the next 10 days. We're weeks away from opening, and it's an unfortunate circumstance.
While Racino developer Michael Moldenhauer says he'll appeal the ruling, the leader of a group which lost out to Raton last year sees new opportunity.
We're excited at the opportunity to file another application and try to get the racetrack there in Tucumcari carries.
Rod Green, KOAT, Action 7 News.
New Mexico's Racing Commission will meet on the 19th to discuss what should happen with the Racino's license.